Rumor has it that several off-duty guards meet in that cabin for an RC combat club.
This is going to be great. I haven't been in any RC combat since that job we pulled in Istanbul. It was awesome.
Murray, heads up.
Hey, fellas. Any of you guys think you can beat the the moose? Maybe put a bet on it.
Oh, I'm in, eh? I ain't got a lot of money for this wager, but there's no way I'd lose to a new guy like you, huh? But I ain't got no money.
That might be okay. It all depends.
Depends on what?
On whether or not you know the location of the Northern Light Battery.
Oh, well, I guess I owe ya.
radio tracking devices. If you could snag enough of them, we should be able to set up a receiver array around Jean Bisson's house.
I'm always up for bugging someone's home.
The first step is crawling into that bear cave and stealing the goods.
I'm on it.
The radio transmitters have all been tagged in their mouths. You'll have to sneak up and pickpocket it while they're yawning.
Sounds safe.
Stay clear of the thin, crackly ice. Walking on it is sure to wake the bears.
I'll keep that in mind.
You'll have to place the radio transmitters in precise locations around Jean Bisson's base of operations.
Seems easy enough.
Once you're in position, hit the circle button to place the transmitter.
Thank you. Reading through the log chopping guide, it's become painfully clear that to win in the lumberjack game, we'll have to cheat. Now, I've constructed a plan that hinges around us acquiring an eagle's egg, which is more difficult than you'd think. First, Murray needs to lure a bear into taking out the local oil mains. Once destroyed, the pressurized oil should ignite and create updrafts, which Sly will then use to paraglide over to the eagle's nest, grab an egg, and then head back to the safe house. Thanks to Murray's undercover work in the RC Combat Club, we've learned that the Northern Light Battery is hidden in a silo nearby. The battery needs some serious modification if we're going to hide inside it to sneak onto Arpeggio's blimp. First, we'll short the battery with grapple lines on local boats. Then, we'll all break into the lighthouse and sever the power flow to the battery. That way it won't recharge. Given my electrical engineering background, this plan has a 97% chance of success. Pretty good, huh?
Thank you.
So, you want me to go in there and bust the thing up? Sounds like work for Murray.
Actually, this job will require all three of our skills. The front door is locked, and you're the only one capable of climbing up to the hatch on top. Once inside, sneak down to the ground floor and let us in. We'll help you finish the job.
All right, see you on the ground floor.
Just let me at that Northern Light attractor. It'll be slag in minutes.
Not quite that simple, Murray. I'll reverse the energy flow from the control computer while you lift the main circuit breaker. That should give Sly a short window of opportunity to climb up the power lines and overload the system from the top.
Up, down, up, down. They should put an elevator in this place.
Thank you.
keep this thing reversed forever.
Yeah, this is heavier than it looks.
Wow. Trust Murray's informant. That's the silo with the battery hidden inside.
To prepare it for travel, we'll have to drain off its northern light energy. By attaching a boat's grappling hook to the top of the silo, we should be able to deplete power from the battery.
Murray's in position to help throw you out onto the boat.
Once on board, I'll hack into its steering controls and move the vessel close enough to fire its grappling hook.
Okay, I'll climb on top of the silo and attach the hooks. How many grappling lines will it take to drain the battery?
3 should suffice. Once the first line's attached, Murray and I will commandeer another boat. You should stay in position.
Finally, I get the easy gig.
I'm all set to throw you to that boat. These days, my aim is impeccable.
Now to hack the steering controls.
Silo. Shoot the grappling hook up to me, and I'll make sure it gets attached to the battery. I should head out for another boat before anyone picks up on what we're doing. hooks in place. One more grapple line to go, and this thing will be on empty. I was wondering what happened to that guy. Guess he just prefers to be frozen.
With the battery chamber empty, we'll be all set to move in.
Thank you.
Gadzooks, that's a nice one!
Thank you.
First have to destroy all the local oil mains.
It looks pretty sturdy. The Murray is strong, but his fists can't punch through metal.
No problem. See that old bear down there? His name is Grizzleface. The guards ignore him because he's blind and practically nerve dead, except for his sense of smell. If that old guy smells fish, there's no stopping him. Use Grizzleface to take out the oil mains.
But I don't smell like fish, do I? How can I lure him around?
Bentley's taken up a post along the river. He'll keep tossing bombs into the water, and the fish should get blown sky high. Plenty should land near your position.
So you want me to throw a fish at the oil main so that old Grizzleface will knock him apart?
That's the idea. You might even try throwing fish at the guards. Might improve their odor. Grizzleface over to the next oil main by luring him with fish.
Come on.
paragliding job off the lighthouse.
Sounds easy enough. Except for the part where I have to swim a half a mile through freezing water.
Why swim when you can paraglide? With the oil mains all destroyed, the pent-up combustible materials have just caught fire.
I see. The updraft created by the flame should give me some extra altitude.
Just make sure to stay out of the fire. Get too close and old Grizzleface will be eating barbecued raccoon for dinner.
That's a charming image, Bentley.
Thank you.
The Lumberjack Games are upon us. Now, despite Murray's study of the log chopping guide, none of us are skilled enough to beat Jean Bisson at his own game. So, though it pains me to say it, we'll have to cheat. Murray, you'll participate in the power log chopping competition. Get us a good score, and then let Bisson up for his turn. While he's chopping, I'll sneak the eagle egg into his trousers, and the protective parents should disturb his axe swings. Sly, given your ascension skills, I've signed you up for the ice wall climb. We'll keep Bisson from beating your score by pulling him off the wall with some nearby grappling lines. And finally, I'll represent our team in the log rolling competition. With my knowledge of rotational mechanics, we're sure to get a stupendous score. Sly will be in charge of greasing Bisson's log, so he has no chance of beating it. If you guys are ready, I say we head out and show these meathead lumberjacks what we're made of.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, let's head down there and win those talents from Jean Bisson. Sly, try to keep a low profile when we get close. We don't want him to recognize you. Excuse me, sir. We humble lumberjacks would like to participate in your lumberjack games.
Think you got what it takes to win the Clockwork Talons, eh? Well, I'm sure enough gonna let you play, so long as you pay the entry fee.
Much obliged, partner. We'll, just take our positions for the competition.
Enjoy the moment while you think you still got a chance. It's as close to winning as you'll ever get. This year's first event will be a power chopping contest. Not like anyone's ever gonna beat my record, but let them try. I was actually expecting better from a big fella like you. Is pathetic, big man. Where'd you learn to chop? From a book? Expecting better from a big fella like you. I was actually expecting better from a big fella like you. Not bad, Hippo. Topo. But watch and learn as I destroy that log without even breaking a sweat.
Okay, Bentley, you're on. Plant the eagle egg on Bisson, and the angry eagle parent should swoop in and throw off his axe timing.
Tell any of you the story about the judge from last year's competition who mistakenly gave me a score other than 10? I see we're tied with only one event to go. Unfortunately for you, I've saved my best event for the last, the spinning log competition.
Okay, looks easy enough. I just need to stay out of the water.
Enjoy your dip in them icy Canadian waters.
You're
one lucky turtle, I'll give you that. But now, watch. Watch how a skilled log roller does it.
This is crazy. John Bisson's got those judges so intimidated, there's no way he can lose.
You're right, Murray. Those guys need to go. Okay, I'm just making this up on the fly, but what if I were to lure the judges one by one into that cave? Once inside, you two will knock them out and take their clothes.
Ingenious! When all three judges have been restrained, we'll be able to don our disguises and take their place at the judges' table. Sly, you can use the alarm clock gadget to distract the judges and lure them into the cave.
That's a great plan, Sly, but you'll have to move fast. Once John Bisson finishes the log rolling event, the gig is up.
John Bisson, Master of the Great North.